Hello there, welcome back to Let's Play Lunar Eternal Blue Blind. I'm the RPG chick. We're just leaving the western side of Nota. And we gotta look for some town or another with some exotic name somewhere north of here. And get into a million friggin' fights on the way, but I'm just curious. What's this way? If anything, nothing. Okay. So we're gonna get into a fight just getting back to where we were, of course. Anyway, let's see what kind of monsters this land has to offer up. Ooh, got killer wasps. They just attack in normal fashion, we'll take their measure. Pretty tough. Four hits. Oh, 47 points. Oh! They really are like... Well, I don't know. When they poison you, they die. Which is interesting. They take themselves out. Which, I don't know if that's wasps or bees. I thought it was bees that did that. Hero's still at full strength, so... Oh, hero leveled up, finally. He's 13. He's still behind everyone. It's always good to see him level up, though, of course. Alright, so... He actually has almost 100 hit points now. It's pretty good. Oh, I must say, I must say thank you to Lunar Bob for pointing this out to me. How we can give things to Ruby. I haven't noticed this, Ruby. So automatically anything you select here will go to Ruby. Which is funny because it's not the give menu, because you can't select Ruby with the give menu, so it's really handy because Ruby has a lot of slots for holding stuff. So I was about to do magic. Anyway, thank you, Lunar Bob. Okay, so at this point, I think just level up the whole party, because it only takes 7 to heal everybody. But if I heal Jean and Lamina, it costs me 8 points, so let's just heal up everybody. Now we're all at full. So Ronfar was thinking that it's quite a ways for us to get to this town, so we'll see just how far that is. Fatal Hoppers. Sorry if my voice is a little lower. It's higher now. I just pulled the mic closer to my face, so it's a good thing. Yeah, let's take their measure. See if these are as tough as the wasps. Okay, they're at least tougher. Nice. Nice, look how much hero I was hitting for, 75 and 80. Swimming around, you can't get anyone. Ooh, thank you. Thank you, Lucia. Didn't even take him out. Wow. I think this one's damaged. Well, these two are damaged, but I think this one's more damaged, perhaps. These things might be pretty susceptible to fire, being fish-like creatures. Oh my god, hero. Oh, Lucia again! Very impressed, very impressed. I don't remember the song starting off at this point. When we get mad with a fight, it usually starts at the beginning, like, dun, 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 you know. Trying to mix it up a little bit, huh? I think we're gonna do this again, because I want to heal up Jean and Hero, so... everybody. Yeah, the theme song would usually start right here. Is there anything this way? New. Hit those again. Oh! I haven't leveled up magic for quite a while. I better do that. Just for you. Lunar Bob, here's the Poe Sword. We'll see butterflies versus wasps. Try a different enemy for that one. Sweet. Oh, it went out of its way to hit her. They hit hard. Oh, wow. Nice, it does still hit for a lot of damage. I might be using that for a while. Oh wait, no. I really could use some healing. Yeah, see, it starts at this point. Interesting. The song. So yeah, those kamikaze attacks are pretty stupid. I mean, he just took himself out, and Lucia's at full strength. What do you want for a bunch of wasps? More little ramps. Gotta love these convenient little ramps they put up for us. Mm. gonna go out all out magic attack here. Oh, I forgot to level up the magic. Magic. I have a roll of toilet paper that I just stuck in front of me. I'm not moving it until I level up the magic. Bye-bye. A couple of us could use a little topping off, but let's just wait on that. Hold on. It's so long, how do I do this again? Is it? It's part of Ruby. It's been a few weeks since I played this game, guys. We can only level up the white ones. I'm really not fond of this line of spells, the chants. So I'm not completely sure if I can level up both, so let's go for ice. Ice is level 11. Yeah, I can't level it up. I can't level up anything. Oh, okay, so we weren't that far behind. So ice is 11, equal to flame now. Okay. Pretty linear here. What a winding passage. Ooh, we got some kind of cave of ice. Let me move my toilet paper roll. Attack from the rear. Get your lube ready. Let's see that new ice attack. If they're not all dead by the time she goes. There you go. Seems to attack for any more damage. Or cause any more damage. Yeah, I really want to level everyone up now. I mean, not level up, but top everyone off. And seems like a good place to save. Oh! I was afraid we were going to some long ice cave of doom here. Hello? Welcome to the village of Zulan. Didn't Ronfar call it something else? We're looking for someone else, for another village, aren't we? That's actually a port town. Speaking of Ronfar, knock it off, Grandpa. You can't scare us with that gravelly voice. Ronfar, is that you, lad? Well, next time tell me when you're going to stop by. Why don't you help us? We're in trouble. I'm tired of your lame excuses, son. Why don't you get off your lazy butt and do something to stop this foe? What foe? I guess he knows what you're talking about, because I don't. Welcome to the little icicle we like to call home. You guys okay? You look like you've never seen snow before. Jean says, I've never seen snow like this before. Have you, Lucia? She says, this place reminds me of the Blue Star. The cold and overwhelming calm is eerie. You guys should get used to the cold, or your stay is going to be very unpleasant. Ruby says, well, duh. Tell me something I don't know. You know, maybe I could start a fire to warm us up a bit. Bonfire says, that's one gamble I don't want to take. Knowing you, it'd be out of hand in no time. Okay. Interesting. Hello, Ice Maiden. This winter has really killed my fishing business. The only good thing to come from it is that I'm starting a fish cream business. Looks like ice cream, but with all the youth-enhancing benefits of fish oil. More fish oil stuff. Amina says, yuck! We want to eat that crap. Sounds terrible. But you'd rather put it on your lips, wouldn't you, Amina? Well, it's not like I wanted your opinion. Besides, my business is going to make me filthy rich. Just wait. You'll see. I think you got her attention now. This monster thing is really ruining our local economy. I mean, this is the coldest winter we've ever had. Lucia says, the monster. Zophar must be behind all of this. People are trying to get out of this snowy country, but I'm going to stay here. I'm a member of the Freezing Blathering Idiots Swim Club. Want to join? I can get you a discount. Every year about this time, we see who can stay in the ice water the longest. I won last year, but it took me 27 weeks to recover from the frostbite. Whatever floats your boat. Or freezes it. This has got to be the worst job in the world. I hate shoveling snow. Ugh, but I wouldn't give someone to do all this work for me. Amina says, no, it couldn't be that easy. Ha, yes. I've got a great idea for a new business. This is going to make a ton of money. Snow shovelers? Now, in order to make this business profitable, I'm going to need you, Ruby. My help? Ooh, I get it. You want me to melt all the snow with my breath, don't you? Correctamundo. With your breath and my brains, we're going to be rich. Read my lips. No way. With your harebrained scheme, I do all the work and you get all the dough. What I wouldn't give for some help in clearing all this snow. I'll help, but I'll have to charge you like 1,000 silver an hour. You know, union and all that. I gotta check these shops, too. Let's talk to these people first. Man alive, I can't believe how cold this place is. I'm thinking of becoming a career sinner. That way I'll get sent straight to a warmer climate. People think that if you're born in the cold weather, you'll get used to it. I like to punch out the guy who said that nonsense. I can't believe my friends talked me into moving here with them. Let's check out the weapons. So far I have no trouble at all affording stuff. Oh, that's the shop that connected. Okay, the armor shop. Boy, it's cold today, isn't it? Tell me, what is it I can do for you? You can sell me stuff. Iron Scimitar. Ritual Dagger. Attack plus 60, huh? I kind of like him with his crossbow, though. A flail. Oh, even better. I mean, that's got a freeze attack, but I don't even use the special attacks. Glass Fan. Definitely sold there. Attack power goes way up. 67 to 89. Nice. I gotta think about this flail. Attack power plus 80. Find out stuff. Plus 50, You know what? I'm gonna hold on to the bow and I'm gonna buy him that flail. I'm just not gonna sell it. Up from 97 to 127 attack power. Ka-ching! Let's sell that other fan. $750 silver. I believe glass is, you know, stronger than iron, but there you go. We buy and sell only armor in this shop. What can I show you? Everything. Plate mail. Shell armor. Iron shield. Iron bracelet for these three. Sure, I'll bite. And we got headbands. Okay. Alright, let's get plate mail for Alex. No trouble affording all this stuff. The game itself seems to be pretty more challenging than the first, but I had trouble affording stuff in the first game. Now it's like, this is, I mean, I wouldn't exactly call it chump change, 2,000 out of 15, well, almost 16,000, but still, easily affordable. His defense power only goes up by 3, but it's worth it, especially since he's relatively weak compared to the rest of us. Iron bracelets for all. The aura dress doesn't help anybody, huh? Up attack power 3 more. Too bad, what's his name? Hero can't use it. Did I call him Alex before? I might have called him Alex. Okay, so those are iron bracelets. I want to check us out. Defense power 13. It's convenient we get to move from one shop to the other. See, she has the aura dress. So is she. Okay. We got that stuff. So we have headbands. I guess she didn't have any head gear before that. Bow, we're gonna hold on to that just in case. Look, I'm holding on to her staff just in case. Alright, let's sell Hero's old armor. What did he have? Iron? Steel. 700. Still have over 12,000 silver. No problem at all. No problem at all. Oops. In. When I promised to marry my man, he promised we'd never be cold. Ha! What a liar. This is the coldest town I've ever seen. Oh, why'd we move here? What am I going to do? The winter isn't close to being over, and our food is low. My wife doesn't know how bad the situation is. We're in big trouble. Well, she's kind of standing right next to you. Boy, my wife is really in a bad mood lately. I think it's cabin fever. Or PMS. Nice. Real nice there, chum. I thought I told you it was my turn to survive the balloon crash. If I don't get to play the hero this time, then I'm not going to play with you. Okay, why are you looking at us instead of looking at your friend when you talk to him? Please just let me sleep. Listen, stupid, if you fall asleep now, you'll never wake up. Whack, slam, bam. I won't let you die on me. Now wake up. Who's he talking to? Come on, talk to Johnny. Cronfro says, geez, the dumb games kids play nowadays. Do you want these people to eat you? Wake up! Huh. Interesting. What is this? What is that? Oh. I don't know what that is. Hello? The mayor is upstairs with his sickly grandchild. I don't know if it's wise to disturb him right now. Disturbing him, that's our business. It's our job. It's our quest. It's our lot in life. If I were a little bigger, I would ram a spear down that monster's throat. That way, my friend could get well again. It sucks being a kid at times like this. You just feel so powerless. If I were all grown up, I'd whip that monster's butt in a second. In fact, I think I'll try it anyway. Okay, so it is upstairs. Are there books I can look at? No, I'm just gonna... How about this? Mm-hmm. Well, there's the mayor. There's other people in here. This is the mayor's house, but he hasn't been outside in days. I think it has something to do with his granddaughter. Damn that monster. If he'd fight fair, I would have beat him to a bloody pulp. Here's a tip. If you think you want to try to fight it, watch out. He fights real dirty. After he kneed me into the groin, I was history. Well, they're all bandaged from their fight, that's why. Please, could you go and fetch me a glass of water? Ruby says, you're injured, but not that bad. Get it yourself. I've killed a bear with my bare hands. I've killed every kind of beast known to man. But this thing? Be afraid. Be very afraid. Okay. Each day she keeps getting worse. I don't think my daughter has the strength to fight the fever anymore. I don't know what I'm going to do. She's the only child I have left. Her father has left the village to find a cure, but he's never returned. I'm so very cold. Mama, where are you? Ruby says, poor thing, she's freezing to death. And she's got a very high temperature. I don't think she's going to make it. Oh, thank the goddess. She has heard my prayers and sent you to save us. I know that you've come a great distance to be here with us today. But please, there is no time to waste. You must defeat this wicked creature. The monster has made us prisoners in our own homes. This cold weather that it has brought upon us has already killed many people. Please, I beg of you, will you please help us? If you won't do it for me, please do it for my granddaughter. She's all I have left. Will you please help us? I'm tired of helping people. And I guess the death toll will continue to increase. Ruby says, Hero, how can you be so self-centered? It's easy. These people need our help. Come on, let's help them. We've tried everything in our power to kill this beast, but we can't. Please think it over one more time. We really need your help. Okay, that beast is history. Oh, you have no idea how happy you've made me. As the mayor, I'll make sure you receive everything you need. Huh. Lucia says, Hero, this is not a decision you can make for all of us. Even if you take the time to save this village, we've wasted valuable time in trying to stop the revival of Zophar. I know that you want to help these people. I can no longer stay with you. Hey! My mission is too important. I suppose this is to be our goodbye. Thank you. Where? Come back. Ugh. Ruby says, I can't believe that Lucia would turn her back on these people. How could she be so heartless? The girl seemed to have pressing business. Thankfully, you were able to stay even though she left. You hurry to the monster cave above this village. I wish I could tell you what to expect inside, but everyone who's been inside has come back with only sketchy details. The boy guarding the entrance to the cave will let you in. Oh boy. Please, you got to help me. Ruby says, come on, we've got to save this girl. I've done nothing but pray to the goddess to help us find a cure. Yet my prayers still go unanswered. Yeah, until now. We go on to fight Lucius. There's no way you can win a fight with the beast without me. Why don't you wait until I feel better? Then I can go with you. No thanks. Because you're never going to feel better. I was in a terrible fight. The beast. I'm injured. I'm in terrible pain. Would you please go get me something to eat? Ruby says, you don't look like you got beaten up by the beast. Well, no. I didn't exactly fight with the monster. I fell down when I was trying to run away from it. I knew it. You coward. Please promise me you won't tell anyone about how I got hurt. They'll never let me live it down. You mustn't go there. He'll kill you. The beast knows no mercy. He thrives on killing innocent people. So the old man talked you into saving our little village, did he? He's always been a great salesman. I just hope you don't get suckered into giving your lives for this village. Alright. Where's the first floor? Is it? Oh, it's here. The stairs. Okay. I just feel so helpless that nothing I do seems to make a difference. I wish I could help you defeat that monster. You are going to try to defeat it, aren't you? It's the only way to make the mayor's granddaughter well again. Okay, we're going to explore the rest of this, and then we're going to go fight that monster. Thanks for watching. See you next time, and a bang, bang, boogie, and don't stop the boogie.